whatever, and something gets in your head and you have to record it. Voice memos are really good for that. I once turned my bedroom walk-in closet into a songwriting cave, trying to force out creativity, and I put Christmas lights everywhere. I was smoking a lot of pot at the time, and I tried to have this like creativity cave that I could go into and shut the door, and it would be real small and isolated, and nothing good ever came out of that. So you can't force creativity, it just kind of comes when it comes. But this one is definitely the weirdest place I ever wrote a song. It's called Public Library.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's really old. It was before I was even in the emo band, so this is really, really old. And it has nothing to do with a public library. It was just written in a public library parking lot really late at night with a guy who's not here tonight. But some of you know Mr. Benbar. He gets a partial credit for this song, and he usually sings it with me.
Empty.
I think I got the secret meaning. I think I got the secret meaning of that song. You said it wasn't about a public library, but I hear the rage against the Dewey Decimal System in there.
Yeah. Yeah, got it.
I hear it. Can't get one past.